King Xerxes ruled over 127 provinces from India to the Upper Nile region of Kush. In the third year of his reign, he threw a banquet for all his nobles and officials. Queen Vashti also gave a banquet for the women in the royal palace of King Xerxes. On the seventh day, when the king was in high spirits from the wine, he commanded his seven eunuchs that served him to bring the queen wearing her royal crown.
Bring to me my beautiful wife, Queen Vashti. I tell you, there's no woman more beautiful in all the land than her. I want to display her beauty to the people and the nobles.
King Xerxes, we delivered your command to the queen and she refused to come.
She what? Refused? Who does she think she is? I need to speak with my seven nobles of Persia and Media. They are experts in matters of law and justice. They will know what to do. Memucan, according to the law, what must be done to Queen Vashti?
Queen Vashti has done wrong, not only against the king, but also against the nobles and peoples of all the provinces of King Xerxes. All the women will know the queen's conduct. They will despise their husbands and say, King Xerxes commanded Queen Vashti to be brought to him, but she would not come. This very day, the Persian and Median women of nobility who have heard about the queen's conduct will respond to all the king's nobles in the same way. There will be no end of disrespect and discord. Therefore, if it pleases the king, issue a royal decree and let it be written in the laws of Persia and Media, which cannot be repealed, that Queen Vashti is never again to enter the presence of King Xerxes. In addition, I think you should give her position to someone better than her. When the king's edict is proclaimed throughout all his vast realm, all the women will respect their husbands, from the least to the greatest.
That is a wonderful idea. I am pleased with your advice. I will issue an edict. Send dispatches to all parts of the kingdom, to each province and to each person in their own language, proclaiming that every man should be ruler over his own household. Now that that's taken care of, there is one small problem. I am all alone. I have no one with whom to share my kingdom. I am a king who does not have a queen.
King Xerxes, let a search be made for beautiful young women for the king. Appoint commissioners in every province to bring all the beautiful girls into the harem at the citadel of Susa. Let beauty treatments be given to them. Then the girl who pleases you can be the new queen.
Good man, you're two for two today. I like that idea. Make it happen, Captain.
In the citadel, there was a Jew named Mordecai who was carried into exile from Jerusalem. Mordecai had a cousin named Esther, whom he raised as his own daughter when her mother and father died. Esther was lovely in form and features. When the king's order and edict had been proclaimed, many girls, including Esther, were taken to the citadel of Susa.
Okay, ladies, line up now. I am Haggai. I was placed in charge of the harem by the king. You will listen to and obey me. It is my responsibility to find a new queen. No one gets to the king without going through me first. Before any woman goes to see King Xerxes, she will have to complete 12 months of beauty treatments. You will be prescribed 6 months of oil of myrrh and 6 months with perfumes and cosmetics. When and if you are elected to see the king, you can have anything you want to take with you from the harem to the king's palace. In the evening, you will go there, and in the morning, you will return to another part of the harem to be placed in the care of Shashgaz, who is in charge of the king's concubines. You will not return to the king unless he is pleased with you and summons you by name. Oh. Hello, little lady. Ooh, I noticed you since you first arrived here last year. What is your name?
Hello, my name is Esther.
Aren't you a darling little lady? Where are you from?
Somewhere.
Somewhere, huh? I've been there. Many times, in fact. What's your nationality?
Human.
So, you're a human from somewhere. Why are you so private? Surely you don't think you'll get past me to the king with those kinds of answers.
My cousin has forbidden me to answer those kinds of questions.
You mean that guy who comes past here every day walking back and forth near the courtyard of the harem? can't see him very well, but I can tell he's watching someone over here.
He just wants to know how I'm doing and what's happening to me. He's very protective of me. Always has been.
Well, I can see why. I have to admit it. I like you. I want you to have beauty treatments and special food. I'm going to assign you 7 maids selected from the king's palace. I am moving you and your maids into the best place in the harem. Okay, ladies, listen up. It's time to send a lucky young lady to see the king. That young lady will be... Esther! King Xerxes, we have our newest contender. This woman has found favor in everyone she has come in contact with. No one has had a negative thing to say about her. May I present to you the lovely and enchanting Esther.
Mamma mia! If you aren't the most beautiful young woman that has come to see me yet. It's like an angel fell from the sky and stands before me. This gala is now over. I have found my queen. Esther, I place this royal crown upon your head. Vashti is no longer queen. It is now Queen Esther. Everyone, all hail your new queen. We will now have a great banquet, Esther's banquet. All my nobles and officials are invited. I proclaim today a holiday throughout the land.
When the young women were assembled a second time, Mordecai was sitting at the king's gate. Two of the king's officials who guarded the gate plotted a conspiracy to assassinate the king. Mordecai told Esther, who then told King Xerxes. When the report was investigated and found out to be true, the two officials were hung. Soon after, the king honored a man named Haman. He was given a seat of honor higher than that of the other noble officials. The king commanded all the royal officials to kneel down to him, but Mordecai would not kneel down or pay him honor.
Mordecai, why do you disobey the king's command?
I am a Jew. I will not kneel down to that man or any other.
Mordecai, what's this I hear? You will not bow down to me, even if the king commands it.
You have heard correctly.
Do you think you're too good to kneel down and pay me honor?
Do you think that you're so good that we should kneel down and honor you? You don't look like God to me.
I must find a way to destroy all the Jews throughout the whole kingdom of Xerxes. King Xerxes, there are certain people who are dispersed and scattered among the people in the provinces of your kingdom whose customs are different from those of other people and who do not obey your laws. It is not in your best interest to tolerate them. If it pleases the king, let a decree be issued to destroy them, and I will put 375 tons of silver in the royal treasury for the men who carry out this business.
Keep the money, and do with the people as you please.
Dispatchers went out by courier to all the king's provinces with the order to kill, destroy, and annihilate all the Jews. Young and old, women and children, on a single day, the 13th day of the 12th month.
Queen Esther, Mordecai is in the city wailing very loudly.
Oh my goodness, is he all right?
No doubt he is upset about the decree.
What decree?
The one that states the Jews will be completely destroyed. Isn't he a Jew?
Send him to me at once.
He is wearing sackcloth. You know that isn't allowed to be worn inside the king's gate.
Send him some clothes to put on and send him to me.
Mordecai, Queen Esther would like you to put on these clothes and see her at once.
No, I will not accept them.
Queen Esther, he would not accept them.
Hatch, come here. I need you to go out to the city and find Mordecai. Find out what's troubling him.
Mordecai, the queen has sent me to find out why you are so distressed.
You want to know why I'm so distressed? Here, read this. Tell me if you'd be dancing and singing zippity-doo all over the place after reading this.
Queen Esther, I've talked to Mordecai. And I've discovered his distress. It seems that the king has issued a decree that on the 13th day of the 12th month, that all the Jews will be obliterated. Then their cattle and goods will be taken as plunder.
Why would the king issue such a decree?
Haman has offered 375 tons of silver for the men to carry out the order. Mordecai asked me to ask you to go into the king's presence and beg for mercy. Plead with him for your people. Queen Esther, are you a Jew?
Go back to Mordecai, send him this message.
Mordecai, the queen sends you a message. All the king's officials and the royal provinces know that any man or woman that approaches the king in the inner court without being summoned will be put to death. The only exception to this is for the king to extend the gold scepter to him and spare his life. But 30 days have gone past since I was called to go to the king.
You tell her I said, just because you're in the king's house, you will be the only Jew to escape. If you remain silent at this time, relief and deliverance for the Jews will arise from another place. But you and your father's family will perish. You were put in this royal position for a time such as this.
Go, gather all of the Jews who are in Susa and fast for me. Do not eat or drink for 3 days. My maids and I will fast as you do. When this is done, I will go to the king, even though it is against the law. If I perish, I perish.
On the third day, Esther put on her royal robes and stood in the inner court of the palace in front of the king's hall. The king was sitting on his royal throne facing the entrance. He saw Queen Esther standing in the court and was pleased. He held out the gold scepter that was in his hand. Esther approached and touched the tip of the scepter.
What is it, Queen Esther? What is your request? Even up to half my kingdom, it will be given to you.
If it pleases the king, let the king along with Haman come to a banquet I have prepared for him.
Certainly. Bring Haman at once so that we may do what Esther asks. Now, what is your petition? It will be given to you. What is your request? It shall be granted.
My petition and my request is this. If the king regards me with favor, and if it pleases the king to grant my petition and fulfill my request, let the king and Haman come tomorrow to the banquet I will prepare for them. Then I will answer your question.
That sounds good to me. I'll see both of you tomorrow.
I will walk you to the king's gate.
Hey, who's that man sitting at the gate?
That is the man Mordecai.
I thought that was him. He neither rose nor showed fear at my presence. He really burns me up.
Hello, Haman. How was the banquet with the king and queen, dear?
The banquet was wonderful, Zeresh. I am wonderful. I have so much. I have vast wealth, you, my beautiful wife, and many sons. The king has honored me and elevated me to the highest position above all the other nobles and officials. Do you realize that I am the only person that Queen Esther invited to accompany the king to the banquet she gave? She also invited me to the banquet she's having with the king tomorrow. But all of this gives me no satisfaction. As long as I see that Jew Mordecai sitting at the king's gate.
How about you have gallows built that are 75 feet high and ask the king to have Mordecai hanged on them? Then you can go to the king's dinner and be happy.
You're a genius! That's a wonderful idea! I'll have them built immediately.
Attendant, come in here.
I am here, O king.
I can't sleep. Read me a bedtime story. Bring me the chronicles of the record since my reign. Entertain me.
Well, some of the most recent entries were when an assassination plot conspired by two of your own officers was uncovered by Mordecai.
Yes,
and then
I remember that. Mordecai saved my life. What honor and recognition have we ever done for him?
Nothing has been done for him.
We haven't done anything for him? I can't believe we overlooked that. We should. Who is in the court?
Haman is standing in the court.
Send him in. Haman, what should be done for the man the king delights to honor?
He must be talking about me. Who is it that the king would rather honor than me? For the man the king delights to honor, have them bring the royal robe the king has worn and a horse the king has ridden. One with a royal crest placed on its head. Then let the robe and the horse be entrusted to one of the king's most noble princes. Let them robe the man the king delights to honor and lead him on the horse through the city streets, proclaiming before him, "This is what's done for the man the king delights to honor."
Go at once. Get the robe and the horse, and do as you have suggested Mordecai the Jew, who sits at the king's gate. Do not neglect anything you have recommended. You
gotta be kidding me.
Haman got the robe and the horse. He robed Mordecai and led him through the city streets and did everything he suggested to the king. Afterward, Mordecai returned to the king's gate, and Haman rushed home with his head covered in grief. He told his wife and friends everything that had happened to him.
I'm telling you, Zeresh, honey, it was awful. How could that Jew get all the praise and honor that was meant for me? It's not fair, I tell you.
Since Mordecai is of Jewish origin, you cannot stand against him. You will surely come to ruin.
Sorry to interrupt, Haman. The king and queen await your presence at the banquet.
I'm ready. At least that Jew Mordecai won't be there. King Xerxes, Queen Esther, I would like to thank you for having me at this banquet for the second time.
Queen Esther, you still haven't told me your petition. What is it? Whatever you want, you will have.
If I have found favor with you, O King, if it pleases your majesty, grant me my life. This is my petition. Spare my people. This is my request. For my people and I have been sold for destruction, slaughter, and annihilation. If we had merely been sold as slaves, I would have kept quiet. But the compensation our adversary offers cannot be compared with the loss you would suffer.
Who is he? Where is the man who has dared to do such a thing?
The adversary and enemy is this vile Haman.
Me? Why, Oh boy.
Excuse me, Queen. I can't stand our present company. I'm stepping out into the garden for some fresh air.
Oh, Queen Esther, please spare my life. The king will surely have me hanged for this. I had no idea you were a Jew. I only wanted to get rid of that man, Mordecai. I did not intend to harm you. Oh, please, Queen Esther, please!
The king is right. It is getting sickening around this table. I think I'll go recline on my couch.
Queen Esther, how can you just lie there on the couch while my life is in your hands? The king will return from the garden any minute, and he will have his men seize me. Only you can spare me because I know his mind is already made up. You have already heard him tell you that anything you ask for, he will give you. If you ask him to spare me, he will listen to you. I see him coming now. Oh, please, Queen Esther, I'm begging you!
Get off me, you fool!
Will he even molest the queen while she is with me in the house?
No, it's not what it looks like!
Yo, King, check it out. A gallows 75 feet high stands by Haman's house. He built it to hang Mordecai on. You know, that nice man who spoke up to save the king's life.
Hang him on it.
After Haman was hanged, the king's fury subsided. That same day, King Xerxes gave Haman's estate to Queen Esther. The queen told the king of her relationship to Mordecai. The king reclaimed his signet ring from Haman and presented it to Mordecai. Then Queen Esther appointed Mordecai over Haman's estate.
Please, O king, please put an end to the evil plan of Haman, which he had devised against the Jews.
Arise, Queen Esther.
If it pleases the king and if he thinks it's the right thing to do, let an order be written overhauling the dispatches Haman devised and wrote to destroy the Jews in all the king's provinces. How can I bear to see disaster fall on my people? How can I bear to see the destruction of my family?
Because Haman attacked the Jews and they hanged him on the gallows, I have given his estate to you. Now write another decree in the king's name on behalf of the Jews as seems best to you. Seal it with the king's signet ring, for no document written in the king's name and sealed with his ring can be revoked.
Mordecai left the king's presence wearing royal garments of blue and white, a large crown of gold, and a purple robe of fine linen. the city of Susa held a joyous celebration. For the Jews, it was a time of happiness and joy, gladness and honor. King Xerxes imposed tribute throughout the empire to its distant shores. Mordecai the Jew was second in rank to King Xerxes. His many fellow Jews held him in high esteem because he worked for the good of his people and spoke up for the welfare of all the Jews.